If you've ever had any interest in skins, you might have come across the term patterns, which is what we are going to be talking about in this lesson of Gamerpay Skin School. All CSGO skins have a pattern. A pattern is simply a number which can range from 1 to 1000 and can change the look of the skin greatly. The number is randomly generated alongside the float once the skin is created through a drop or unboxing. A pattern is simply an image of a visual design which is applied to the weapon. The pattern number is then what decides what part of the image will be used for the skin. And just like with floats, the pattern number cannot be changed. You could argue there's two types of patterns. One type where the pattern has no influence on how the skin looks, and another type where the pattern number has a great influence on how the skin looks. However, it is a bit more complicated than that, as there's also some skins where the pattern number will change the look of the skin slightly, but not to the point where it affects the price of the skin. But if we just divide the pattern categories into two, the AK-47 Asimov is an example of a skin where the pattern number has no influence on how the skin looks. And an example of a skin where the pattern number has a great impact on how the skin looks could be the Case Hardened. Other skins like Fade, Crimson Rip, and Slaughter are also skins where the pattern number affects the look of the skin to the point where the price can change. However, the skin where the pattern has the highest importance by far is the Case Hardened, which is what we are going to be focusing on in this video. To explain a bit more about the importance for patterns on Case Hardened skins, I've invited the popular blue gem collector and trader Creek, who will now be sharing his knowledge and talking about the three different types of patterns for the Case Hardened skin.
With each Case Hardened, you have about 1,000 patterns, and depending on the wear, the percentage of blue and the positioning, it can really have a high impact on the knife's value. And also with these Case Hardened, you have different types of patterns. First of all, you have blue gems. And for a knife to be an actual blue gem, it has to have at least 70% blue coverage. And with blue, I also mean sky blue. So if there are any spots of purple present, in most cases, they aren't considered as blue gems unless the percentage is really high. Next to that, you also have blaze gems. And here I have an example. These are quite similar to blue gems, but the main difference with these are is that they have actual gold and purple bits inside of them. And people only really consider these type of nice blaze gems when the coverage is 100% consisting of blue, purple, and gold. And next to that, you also have other Case Hardened called gold gems. These are AKs or knives with also a very high percentage of gold instead of blue, and these can also impact the value. And you also have a very niche community who really likes these and are willing to overpay quite a bit for them.
You talked a bit about like the past sales is going to affect the blue gems value, but like how would you define a blue gems value?
So, like I said, there are three main factors: blue percentage, which is the most important, second of all, the wear, and third of all, the positioning. The percentage of blue, I think, is pretty obvious. The higher percentage of blue you have across your blade, the higher its value is, the more sought after and more beautiful it is in game. Then also the wear. Most people like blue gems in better conditions, such as field-tested minimal wear. Those are the most sought after. Battle scarred and factory new is a lot more tricky because the higher the wear is, the more dark it looks. But this is also personal. You have a lot of people who also enjoy high float blue gems, but in general, lower floats are much easier to sell and much more in demand. And then, as I mentioned, the positioning is also really important because most people like their blue gems when they're based on the tip. So if you have a tip-based blue gem, it is worth a lot more than it is a blue gem with blue in the middle or blue at the bottom, by example. And also, if the blue is all over the place, the demand is much lower than if it is in one clean spot.
Now, to add to what Krieg just explained, I'd like to give some examples of pattern numbers for the different pattern types. For the blue gem, one of the most important patterns is the infamous AK-47 Case Hardened with the pattern 661, which looks like this. A lot of the time referred to as the scar pattern due to the little gold spot at the end of the weapon. For the Gold Gym, one of the most important patterns is the AK-47 case harden with the pattern number 784. And finally, for the Blaze Gym, one of the most popular patterns is the AK-47 case harden with the pattern 571. The number of the pattern on the case harden skins is important across all weapons, but has the biggest impact on the price on the Karambit and AK-47. Most case harden skins are also ranked in different tiers, ranging from tier 1 to tier 4. These pattern numbers I just mentioned are considered tier 1 by most of the community, but it is subjective what tier a pattern number belongs in, as Valve has not made any official tier list. And that wraps up the fourth lesson of Gameplay Skin School. I hope you learned something new in this lesson, and I'll catch you in the next lesson.